Hi, welcome back to Power Electronics Lectures. In this video, I'll talk about the importance of high efficiency in power electronics systems. We said that high energy efficiency provides the power electronics systems with many advantages, such as the dropping the cost of the system, either the operating cost or the installation cost. Since the power electronics provide the link to integrate more renewable energy resources to the traditional system, so they contribute less to the global warming. Also, because we use smaller size and compact size in power electronic systems, so the surface that we need to cool is much smaller than the traditional system, so the size of the heat sink and the cooling system will be much smaller if you compare it to the traditional power systems. In power electronic systems, the cooling systems such as heatsink, fan, airflow, all these are designed to transfer the dissipated power to heat, which mainly losses, without allowing the internal temperature of the converter to exceed a certain limit. Why do we need this limit? Because some components are designed to operate at certain temperature, and if we exceed this temperature, the component will be not functioning well as required, or it can be damaged. So let's say that this block represent a converter. So here, let's say this is a power electronics converter or equipment. Okay, so if the system is supplied by a power source, we hope that we get the same power at the output, but unfortunately here in the input you'll find that this system, this converter, dissipates some temperature, dissipate some power, and this power can be either temperature or any other type of losses. So let's say these are all losses, okay, and ultimately we get a smaller power at the output. By definition, the efficiency, let's say efficiency is equal to eta. This is defined as the output power, P out, over the input power. And as we know that the input power is equal to the losses plus the output power, right? Let's redefine this efficiency equation again here. So eta is equal to the output power over the input power, which is the output power plus the power losses. Just try to distribute this. You will find that efficiency times P out plus P loss is equal to P out. Okay, do some simplifications here. So eta P out plus eta P loss is equal to P out. Take these together, so here you'll get that 1 minus eta times P out is equal to eta times P losses. So calculate the output power with respect to the losses. You will find that the output power is equal to eta over 1 minus eta times P loss. So now we have the output power with respect to the power losses only. Why we do this? Because now we need to see what is the importance of these losses. What is the effect of these losses? Do we have a small effect to the output power, or do we have a huge effect on the output power? Let's consider this example where we have a power electronics converter, and this converter is designed to tolerate up to 220 watt losses. What we will do is to compare the output power capability if the conversion efficiency increased from 85% to 95%. So let's say instead of that, let's say we have two converters. The first one comes with efficiency 85% efficiency, and the other one has a better efficiency, which is 95% efficiency. Okay, and we need to compare these two converters. Okay, if both have the same losses, so here both lose the same amount of power, which is 220 watt. Okay, but for some reason these two converters, one has a better efficiency than the other, but both of them, let's say they use the same number of components, so they lose the same amount of power. Okay, and here we have the input power Pin and Pout. If we try to calculate the power for the first converter, you'll find that the output power is equal to how much? 0.85, the efficiency, over 1 minus 0.85 times the losses, which are 220 watt. Calculate this, you'll get 1.246 kilowatt. So this is the output power that you can get from the first converter if this converter lose, if you manage to keep the losses up to 220 watt. Okay, if you try to calculate the output power for the second converter, you'll find that P out for the second converter is equal to 0.95 over 1 minus 0.95 times 220 losses, and this will be 4.18 kilowatt. So just compare the power, the output power between these two converters. We just increased 10% of efficiency. We managed to get almost 3 times output power from the converter. So using the same components and keeping the same power losses, we can increase the power capability from 1.246 kilowatt to 4.18 kilowatt, which is almost 3 times, if we manage to increase the efficiency from 85% to 95%. Next video, we'll talk about the structure of power electronics interfaces, so see you next time.